Hey, what's up, guys? I'm Andy Lopez.
And I'm Ariana Torres, and welcome back to the RedHawk broadcast,
where the news flies and the students soar. For today's episode, we have lots of surprises for you guys.
But we want to start off this episode with a quick game of fact or fiction.
Hey, what's up, guys? I'm Andy Lopez, and your host for Fact or Fiction. Let's get right to it. For the first fact or fiction, Scotland's national animal is a unicorn. If you answered fact, you are correct. For the second fact or fiction, honey never spoils. If you answered fact, you are correct. And for the third fact or fiction, if you answer fact, you are correct. Thank you for playing with me, and let's head back to the studio.
Welcome back, you guys. Here are some important dates you should look out for. I'm pretty excited for the break we have coming up.
But you know what I'm more excited for? This new segment called Top 10 Essentials with Addison Expolius and special guest Ulysses Galvin.
Hey guys, it's me, Addison, with a new segment called 10 Things I Can't Live Without with a special guest, Ulysses. Let's get right into it. My first essential would obviously be my family.
My first item would be my shoes, my first pair of J's. They mean a lot to me, so my number one item.
My second item would also be my shoes.
My second item would be my AirPods. I'm always listening to music, especially when I'm about to work out or go out.
My third item would also be music.
My third item would be my phone. I'm always calling and texting my girlfriend, so I gotta keep it close to me.
My fourth item would probably be fruit.
My fourth item would be my soccer ball. I'm always playing soccer, so yeah.
And lastly, my fifth item would probably be my cat.
My fifth item would be water. So remember, stay hydrated and drink a lot of water.
Thank you for playing. Let's head back to the studio.
That was one solid list, but they forgot the one essential thing, sports. Here's Rob with the sports interview.
What's up, guys? I'm here today with Daniel O'Sullivan, otherwise known as Sully, a varsity baseball player who recently just got a scholarship to Menlo College. How are you doing today, Sully?
I'm pretty good.
That's great to hear. We're just gonna hop into the straight question right away, and that question is, what was your reaction when you found out you got your scholarship to Menlo?
I was in disbelief and a lot of shock, just because it was so hard to get recruited during this whole pandemic, and it was just came out of the blue, to be honest. Like, I had a bunch of other offers, but never with, you know, money involved. But I had a bunch of places I could play, but never with money involved, and it just kind of came out of nowhere.
Right, I bet it was great to see all your hard work finally paying off in that scholarship.
Mm-hmm.
How far do you expect that you guys will actually go this year in baseball?
I think we'll go really far. As I don't know if they're having state or anything because of COVID restrictions, but if they do, I think we'll win it all. I think we look really good this year. We have extreme depth in pitching, and we just look really good. Once the weather warms up, our bats will warm up, and I think we look really good.
It's great to hear. We love the confidence from you guys. We love how you guys are performing. Make sure you guys keep up the good work, and thank you for your time, Sully.
Thank you for having this.
That's all we have this week for a sports interview. Now on to sports with Neo and Andy.
Hey, what's going on, guys? I'm Neo.
And I'm Andy Lopez.
Welcome back to RedHawk Sports. To start off, tennis had two back-to-back wins against Sutter and Paradise. Emily Cerny finished off her season strong, getting three wins in a row. Also, she won MVP.
Unfortunately, girls' soccer team lost on Tuesday against Winters.
On the same day, the boys' soccer team also lost, only by a score of 1 point, though.
But to end on a good note, both JV and varsity baseball team are going undefeated, so a big congratulations to them.
Yep, good job to them. And track starts April 27th, so any of you guys that are playing track, make sure to prepare for that. That's it for RedHawk Sports. Thanks for watching. Catch you later.
We've been having such beautiful weather lately. But let's hear more about it with Neo with the weather update.
Hey, what's up, guys? I'm Neo. Thanks for watching the RedHawk broadcast. I'm sure you guys have noticed the weather has been looking a lot better lately, and it's going to continue to improve. It looks like we're going to have some sunny days in our future, so dress light. That's it for this update. I'll send y'all back to Andy and Ari.
Hey everyone, we're back. Right now would be the perfect time to tell you guys about Poetry Out Loud. For more information, here's Emiliano.
Time to update you all on Poetry Out Loud. Speaking in front of a crowd is not easy, especially reciting a poem, but these students came through and won first, second, and third. Chloe Akumada, Selma Gonzalez, and Renee Ryzinski. Congratulations to everyone who participated. Can't wait for next year.
That was this episode of the RHBC.
Thank you guys for watching. Until next time.
Bye, CHS.